EB4U Custom Conversions. And welcome to another episode in our series of how to convert your car from gas to electric. In last week's episode, we talked about some of the different lithium battery chemistries, as well as placement, containment, care, and safety of lithium batteries. In this week's episode, we're going to continue to talk about batteries, but we're going to talk about your battery pack. And so we're going to talk about the battery pack size, how many cells do you need, how to calculate range, which will determine battery pack size, and of course, balancing weight, range, and cost. So stay with me. Here I have a lithium battery cell. And we can't power a car with just one of these. So how many do we need? First, we're going to need to discuss a little bit about series parallel arrangements. So we can either wire these in series or wire them in parallel or a combination of both. But let's talk a little bit about the idiosyncrasies of each of those configurations.
So let's discuss series and parallel circuits real quick. We're going to use, in this example, we're going to use four of the lithium iron phosphate cells, the nominal voltage of which is 3.3 volts per cell, and they're going to be, for this example, 100 ampere hour cells. So this cell right here is 3.3 volts and 100 amp hours. Now, if we wire those in parallel, which means that all of our negatives are wired together and all of our positive terminals are wired together, what that does is that adds capacity, but the voltage stays the same. So what we have wiring four of those cells together in parallel is we have 3.3 volts and 400 amp hours. Okay? Now if we wire them in parallel, that's where we connect the positive to the negative, positive to the negative, positive to the negative. In that configuration, the voltage adds, but the capacity stays the same. So in this example of four of these cells, 3.3 volts times four is 13.2 volts at 100 amp hours. Okay? So let's take a look at that on the workbench. All right, so here's four cells. These four cells are just like the ones we drew on the board. These are lithium iron manganese phosphate. So their nominal voltage is 3.2 volts. And so let's take a look. And I don't know if you can see this or not. Okay, looks like you can. So it looks like we have 3.23, 3.23, 3.21, 3.25. Okay, so those are the individual cells. So now let's hook them up in parallel and take a reading. So what you see is we've now wired up these four cells in parallel, positive to positive, all the positives connected together, all the negatives connected together. So in essence, what we've done is we've created a 3.2 volt 400 ampere hour battery. And so let's see if that's true. That's 3.23 volts. And you'll see that it'll be the same all the way across. Now that they're in parallel, the little differences have balanced out, and it'll be the same all the way down. Okay? So now let's wire it up in series and see what we get. So now we have the cells wired in series. So we go, here's our negative. So we're going positive to negative, positive to negative, positive to negative, and there's our positive. So our voltage will add between these four cells. So this will be our negative, this will be our positive. So between there, we should have that 3.2 times 4. And we're getting 12.94 volts, which, remember when we did them individually, we had 3.23, 3.23, 3.24, 3.21, and if you add all those up, it comes out to 12.94. So we know we're going to need more than 3.3 volts in our, or 3.2 if we use the lithium, iron, manganese, phosphate cells. We know we're going to need more than that to power a car. 3.3 or 3.2 volts just isn't going to do it. 12 or 13 volts isn't going to do it. So I think it becomes obvious that we're going to have to wire up our lithium cells in series in order to get the voltage we need to move the vehicle. So just how many do we need?
So the number of cells in series will determine the voltage of our pack, but it will also determine the weight and cost of our
pack. So how many cells do we need?
Well, the voltage of our battery pack needs to be compatible with the motor controller that we select to go with our vehicle. And we'll talk about motor controller selection in a future video. Now, along with the battery pack voltage being compatible with our motor controller selection, we have other things that will need to be compatible with that battery pack, such as our heater, our DC to DC converter, air conditioning, any accessory that runs off of pack voltage will have to be compatible with that range of voltage of our pack. So the number of cells in series and the capacity of those cells, the amp hour rating of those cells, will determine the total capacity of our battery pack. So now we're going to figure, how do we figure that capacity? So for that, we're going to visit Ohm's law. So Ohm's law states that volts times amps equals watts. And volts is the measurement of potential difference of our cells. And amps is the rating for the current. And watts is the unit of power. Okay, so we're trying to figure out how much power is in our battery pack. And so we know that the volts will be calculated by taking the number of cells and multiplying that times our individual cell voltage. And then this is going to be the amp hour rating of our cells. So volts times amp hours equals watt hours. Okay? So let's do the math. Okay. So we're going to use a couple examples here. And for the examples, we're going to make an assumption. Let's assume that we're going to have a battery pack of 145 volts. Okay, now 145 volts equals how many cells? Well, we're going to use the LiPo 4 cells for this example, 3.3 volts per cell. So we divide that by 3.3. And that would give us 44 cells. Okay? And in this example, let's assume that the cells are 180 amp hours. So we have 44 180 amp hour cells and a voltage of 145 volts. Using Ohm's law, we're going to know the total capacity.
So we're going to multiply volts times amp hours. So 145 times 180, which equals 26,100. And that would be amp hours. Watt hours, I'm sorry. So 145 volts times 180 amp hours is 26,100 watt hours. Or stated another way, 26.1 kilowatt hours. That's the total capacity of the battery pack. That's the total capacity of the battery pack, but not 100% of the capacity is usable. With the lithium iron phosphate cells, 80% of that capacity is usable. So we're going to have a usable capacity of 20,000 900 watt hours. Or again, that'd be 20.9 kilowatt hours. That's the usable capacity of our battery pack. So now we can move on to figuring out range. Well, to figure range, we need to know a couple things. We need to know, how much energy does it take to move that vehicle?
Well, how much energy does it take to move your car? Well, I can tell you, if I had to push one, I'd rather push this Miata than that four-wheel drive pickup.
Also need to know how much energy is in our battery pack. And that we just calculated. So we know that. So now we have to figure out, how much energy does it take to move the vehicle? Well, after converting and driving a lot of vehicles, we've come up with the following formula. We're going to take the vehicle weight and divide it by 10. In doing that, it's going to give us the watt hours per mile. This is the capacity in our battery pack, and this formula would give us the watt hours per mile. So now, in this example, let's assume that the vehicle is 2,700 pounds. Okay? So 2,700 pounds divided by 10 equals 270 watt hours per mile to move that vehicle. Now that we have the capacity of our pack and the energy required to move the vehicle, we can now calculate the range. Now, when you're coming up with this figure right here, your 2,700 pounds, always remember it's the weight of the vehicle plus any passengers and cargo. I've known people that have made calculations based solely on the vehicle weight and then found out they were coming up short. They forgot to figure themselves into the equation. So let's do the math. What we're going to do is we're going to take the 20,900 watts, or watt hours I mean, and divide that by the 270 watt hours per mile, and that's going to give us the range, which in this example would be 77 miles. So that was our range right there. 77 miles. Now, let's do one more example. This is an average. The equation is basically figured on an average of different types of driving. So On the freeway, you may get a little better than that, and in town, you may get a little worse. But combined driving, most vehicles fall under that formula, and that tends to be a pretty accurate number. We're going to sum up that first example. It's a 2,700 pound car, 145 volt system, 180 amp hour pack, takes 270 watt hours per mile to move the vehicle, and we had a 77 mile range. The pack weight, based on 44 180 amp hour cells, is 550 pounds. And the approximate pack cost is $11,000. So now, let's go to example number two. Example number two is a lighter car. We're 500 pounds lighter. We're gonna go with 2,200 pounds in this example. Same voltage, we're still running 44 cells, but this time we're running smaller cells. They're only 100 ampere hour cells. So what's the capacity of this vehicle in this example? Well, we're gonna take our voltage and we're gonna multiply that times our amp hour rating. So that's gonna equal 14,500 watt hours or 14.5 kilowatt hours, okay? That's our total capacity, but remember, only 80% is usable, so our usable will equal, check my notes here, 11,600 or 11.6 kilowatt hours. That's usable, okay? So now to figure our range, remember, we're gonna take our usable capacity, so 11,600 watt hours, and we're gonna divide that by the watt hours per mile. Well, the watt hours per mile, remember, we're gonna take the weight of the vehicle, and we're gonna divide that by 10, so it's gonna be 220 watt hours. So we'll divide that by 220, and that'll give us our range of 53 miles. So let's put the two examples up here kind of side by side. Example number two was the 2,200 pound car. Both are the same voltage, 145 volts. This had smaller cells at 100 amp hour apiece. And so it only takes 220 watt hours per mile to move this one. And because we have smaller cells, we have a 50 mile range, 53 mile range, I mean. But the pack weight's less at 308 volts or pounds, and the pack cost is less also at 6,500. So the difference, well, the difference in weight is gonna be 242 pounds. And the difference in cost is gonna be $4,500. And the difference in range will be 22 miles. So, just an example. You know, you could start off with this one and say, hey, if I go with a little bit lighter car, a little bit less on the pack cost, and a little bit less range. But what if I want to add range? Well, you could see by changing, going from 100 ampere hour cells to 180 ampere hour cells, increased our weight. The increased weight increased our energy per mile. But we also increased our range by 22 miles. Pack weight went up, and of course the cost went up. So those are decisions that only you can make. So you can see how weight affects
the range and cost. In other words, we could take this same example right here, and all we do is change the weight. Let's change this to 2,000 pounds. If we did that, the watt hours per mile would go down and the range would go up. So if all we did was start with a lighter car, and so we go from a 2,700 pound car to a 2,000 pound car, you know, same number of cells, same size of cells, only now our watt hour per mile would drop down, and our 77 mile range would go up to 105 miles. Okay? And so the pack weight and cost would be the same, but we would have greater range. That's why weight is important. To keep the weight down, we can keep the range up. If you're starting with a heavier vehicle, in order to get the range up, you would have to add either more batteries or larger capacity batteries, which would increase the weight and the cost. And we could do example after example and work out what worked for us. So if range is important to you, I would suggest that you start with a light vehicle that has low rolling resistance and a low drag coefficient, like we talked about in our last episode. And like I mentioned before, you want to be accurate about your weight. You know, be accurate, and remember to consider all the variables, such as passengers and cargo. And the other thing is to be honest with your range requirements. A lot of people want 200 or 300 miles of range. In reality, in 2014, the average American drove 31 miles per day, according to the Department of Transportation. Expressed another way, 80% of Americans drive less than 40 miles per day. And on any given day, less than 7% of the US population drive 100 miles or more. So you can see that range costs money, weight costs money. All right, my weekly recommendation? Well, this week, it's make yourself a spreadsheet. You know, if you make a spreadsheet on your computer, then you can change these variables and very quickly see how the big picture is affected. Let me show you an example. So here I have a little spreadsheet. This just allows me to make those calculations quickly. I can change the pack voltage, the amp hours rating of my cells, or the vehicle weight. And it tells me the pack size in kilowatt hours, the energy per mile, the maximum safe range, and the number of cells. So if I change this to, say, 120 volts, you can see that the range went down, number of cells went down, but because the weight stayed the same, the energy per mile stayed the same, the capacity went down. Let's take this up to 170. Okay, you can see how our range went up, number of cells went up. Let's keep that the same, but change those cells to 100 amp hour cells. Well, number of cells stays the same, range went down, so forth. Let's see what the weight does here. Let's take this down to 1,500 pounds. Okay, you can see what a difference that made. Let's take it up to 2,500. So you can see very quickly how adjusting the number of cells, the capacity of the cells, and the weight of the vehicle affect
you know, these variables. And we could add another one in here, just put in the price of the cells, and so then it would automatically figure the price change also. So as the number of cells went up, and depending on the size of cell you had selected, you would see the price change also. So that's my recommendation, because this will help you quickly and easily figure out that big picture when it comes to the balancing weight range.
Well, in next week's video, we're going to talk about motors and controllers. So as always, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next Wednesday.